Hello everybody and welcome back to this tutorial, and let us introduce ourselves with a new thing that we are going to learn right now, which is the if statement in Python 3. Now this is the first actual kind of a loop that we are going to do, and basically this is really important, so make sure to pay attention. It is not that hard, especially this tutorial, which is going to be just the basic stuff for the if statement. In the next two tutorials, we're also going to cover the if-else statement and the if-else statement with multiple else-if statements, if you understood what I'm saying. But for now on, let us just cover the if statement only, so open up your IDLE as usual. And right here, basically, we can just try to perform the simple if-else statement, or just if statement in this tutorial. So if you just type here, if, you can see it already gets flagged as a word that comes in Python, so it already gets color. So if, what this basically does is it will look like this. So if something, now of course we don't have variable something, but we'll just use it just for the demonstration purposes. If something equals to something, two dots, then you need to tab the next line. As you can see, it tabs by default, do something. And we can see invalid syntax, of course, because this is not something that actually exists, but this is the basic idea behind the if statement. So for example, we can do something like this. A equals 3. B equals 3, and we can just try to do like this. So if A equals equals to B, two dots, make sure to tab everything in, because if you don't tab it in, which the actual interpreter in Python 3 does by default, but if you're using some text editor and you don't tab it in, it will not be considered as a part of the actual if statement. So if A equals equals B, print. And we can print basically anything we want. We can print these two values are the same! Exclamation mark. You just press here enter once again, and you can see right here we get printed out these two values are the same. But let's see what happens once actually B is not equal to A. So A equals 3, B equals 4. And we will do basically the same thing. So if A equals equals to B, and we will print the same string. So these two values, whoops, values are the same! Exclamation mark. And if I just press here enter once again, you can see right now nothing gets printed out. So this is an if statement. It is only used once something is equal to something, or when some statement is fulfilled, such as in the first example right here. A was equal to B, therefore we did this. Now of course this is not really that useful of an example. What you want to do in a real life program is basically you want to do some useful task once A equals to B, for example. So let's do it. Let's do something like this. So let's set A to be equal to 5, B to be equal to 5, and if A equal equal to B, we can do something like this. A equals A times B, which will basically make an A after this if statement to be equal to 25. So we can do it like this. Press here enter, our if statement has finished, and if I just type here A, you can see right now A is no longer 5, A is right now 25. So let me just check right here. You don't really need to use always this equal equal, you can use something like this. So if B is smaller than A, which currently it is since A is 25, you can print B, or B is smaller than A. Close the actual bracket right here, press enter, and we get printed out B is smaller than A. So this is basically a simple example of the if statement. What we are going to do in the next video is basically cover the if-else statement, which is going to add another statement in case that this one is not fulfilled. So for example, imagine if this is not fulfilled, then we need to do something else, and that else will be in an if-else statement. So hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope I see you in the next one. Bye!